General Motors and the government reached a settlement today over how the automaker handled a defect that led to deaths, injuries, and the recall of millions of vehicles. The agreement may resolve many of the cases, but some remain concerned that the government may have let GM off too lightly. Hari Sreenivasan has the story from our New York studios.
This office and GM have entered into a deferred prosecution agreement.
The formal announcement from U.S. Attorney Preet Bharara in New York followed years of recalls, lawsuits, and congressional hearings. GM agreed to pay $900 million over faulty ignition switches that shut off engines and disabled safety systems. The company now admits it hid the deadly defect for more than a decade.
They didn't tell the truth in the best way that they should have to their regulator and to the public about a serious safety issue that risked life and limb.
An independent monitor will check GM's compliance, and pending criminal charges could be dropped after 3 years. But the deal does have its critics. In a statement today, Democratic Senators Ed Markey and Richard Blumenthal said, the 124 families who lost loved ones deserved individual criminal accountability. It is shameful that they will not be held fully accountable. Back in New York, Prosecutor Bharara defended the agreement.
We're not done. And it remains possible that we will charge, an individual. But the law doesn't always let us do what we wish, we could do.
And in Warren, Michigan, GM's chief Mary Barra summed up the automaker's perspective at an employee town hall.
This is a tough agreement. It further highlights the mistakes that were made by certain people in GM, and it imposes significant penalties and obligations.
GM also said today it will spend $575 million to settle civil lawsuits.
Let's learn more about this settlement and the questions surrounding a lack of charges. David Shepardson of the Detroit News was at today's press conference, joins me now. So it seems that we kind of learned today the limits of the law. GM wasn't necessarily found guilty of the ignition switch problem, but more of the wire fraud connected to the cover-up.
It's basically the same charge the federal prosecutors have used for years for gangs and different crimes, using a telephone or any electronic device across state lines. And the U.S. attorney said there is not a statute that makes it a crime solely for an auto company to sell defective vehicles. And they were not able to determine whether individual employees, were engaged in a cover-up or intentionally committing a crime without that specific statute. And so they said they're not giving up and they're not ruling out any criminal charges in the long run. But realistically, this is probably the end of the criminal side of this case.
A lot of families of the victims are saying, listen, my loved one died and there's not a single human being at General Motors that's responsible for this, that we can find criminally negligent here.
Right, you've got 124 deaths at GM's independent compensation fund is tied to this, 270 injuries, some of them very serious. And what the U.S. attorney said is GM had this siloed culture where no one was taking responsibility. And the CEO has called it a culture of incompetence and neglect. And essentially, because of this huge incompetent company, no one is being held responsible. And it is, like I said, there are a lot of families, and the U.S. attorney personally met with the families and, said he was sorry, and he said they're as aggressive as any other office in the country, but they can't find a statute to specifically go after those individual employees.
That's probably discomforting for any auto owner that there is no law that can actually prosecute this. But how much has GM paid so far? And it seems like this is less than what Toyota was fined with for the sticky accelerator problem a couple of years ago.
That's right. In fact, the Toyota sudden acceleration problem, which was linked to about 5 or 6 deaths, resulted in a $1.2 billion fine. GM is paying to the U.S. government $900 million. There's about $1.2 billion more in settlements of lawsuits, including to shareholders and people who sued over ignition switch defects. And then there's the independent compensation fund that's awarded about $600 million. What the U.S. attorney said was, we are essentially going easier on GM because they fully cooperated. Not only did their attorneys turn over information to us before they even told the executives, but they created this compensation fund and they quickly said, we're going to change our culture. Toyota was accused of misleading government regulators and not coming clean for much longer. It took them 4.5 years to reach that settlement. So that's part of the reason for the difference in the fines.
All right. And this also doesn't count what it's going to cost to fix the ignition switches of all these recalled cars.
That's right. GM last year took about $4 billion in charges for much of the 30 million vehicles they recalled, including another 12 million vehicles beyond the ones involved in this criminal case for other ignition problems, for other key issues. So, you know, the expenses are significant. There's many hundreds of lawsuits left to be resolved, so it's not over yet.
What are the next steps? Is GM essentially on some sort of probation for the next 3 years? They didn't have to admit any wrongdoing, but keep their nose clean?
Well, they didn't have to plead guilty. They were charged with two felonies, but they were required to admit to the information that's laid out in these two charges. And so for the next 3 years, they'll have a consent decree. They will be on probation. If they violate the law, the government could seek to reinstate those felonies and actually go through a conviction. But the reality is there are not a lot of penalties for a big company. Companies don't go to jail. You know, individuals do. And for the most part, you know, Wall Street had basically baked in this cost of the settlement, so the stock was up a little bit today.
All right, David Shepardson of the Detroit News, thanks so much.
Thanks, Ari.